Hello, everyone. Our next speaker is Jesus Perez Sanchez, founder of Finovating. As you probably know by now, we partnered with Finovating on the content and on several other levels on this conference. So it's the chance to thank you, Jesus. Jesus Perez Sanchez is one of the founders of Civeta Investment Venture Capital and is an investment director at FinTech Venture. Both firms are the most successful venture capitals in Spain. He's also the founder of Agile Spain and the Spanish FinTech and InsurTech Association. He has experience working for BBVA, Telefonica, and Santander. Jesus, please.
So, good afternoon. So, interesting topic. So at a time with a lot of people always say that there are no value in Bitcoin, even people who work in financial institutions, let me try to answer the question on how much Bitcoin is worth. Okay, so there are not really a right answer. I think we have all the people can think that we underestimate or overestimate Bitcoin, but the real thing is the markets every day are really giving price to what all the consensus is giving the price of Bitcoin, because really the markets are the best way really to create price and to create really what a consensus of the price. So I am leading one of the I think unique digital programs about valuation of digital assets, not only Bitcoin, you know, always a lot of more digital assets. I think in the next years we'll be out of people analyzing the value of digital assets. And I have experience in right now with a fund, a crypto fund, Economy, that is one of the best ones, and with profit in the last 3 months. Okay, so if I have to define myself what I think about Bitcoin, I will define like a Bitcoin rationalist. So I think really the big opportunity here is that I think we have a better way, better implementation of money. I think that's the best idea. I think we have invented a money that is even efficient, even better. So, and at that point, Bitcoin probably is the best option that we have. But we have to really to all the time to consider if in that moment is Bitcoin the best option or not, okay? But for me, what is sure is that this kind of crypto money is one of the things that have changed the world as we know, and they are becoming be used a lot. So the first thing we have to take in consideration when we invest is what are the main advantages, competitive advantages. I have not too many time in 20 minutes to take in the depth of what are the main advantages, but I'm going to draw my conclusion of that, okay? So I think it's no question that crypto money is better than fiat or digital fiat money. I don't have to take in depth because here in this session, I think we have to discuss about what is the price of Bitcoin, but you can see that there are a lot of things that you can do with crypto money that you cannot do with fiat money. I think that, for sure, is the big advantage. A lot of people that really doesn't think that this Bitcoin is not so superior usually try to instead of recognize. It's very hard really to say that Bitcoin is not a superior technology. It's really hard to really to maintain a discussion of that. The people who not admit Bitcoin usually use blockchain instead of that because it sounds better. But there are a lot of people really trying to do a lot of non-serial value added project in blockchain because they don't understand that Bitcoin blockchain is one of the components of Bitcoin. It's not all the puzzle. So the really important thing is we have create money, decentralized money, and that's the more important thing. If you really think that blockchain is really the main important issue, you are really misconsidering a lot of things. So my main investigation about that is really Bitcoin the best option? And at the moment, is the best option I have to invest? So every time, as the other discussion for me doesn't make sense, what I have to focus is Bitcoin the best option? Because there are a lot of options. Is Libra, that we don't know if will be considered as crypto money or not, that's another interesting topic. Is Libra a competitor? Can really be better implementation of a crypto money? That's really what I do a lot of time investing in discussion that. Is Bitcoin Cash? Is Ethereum a better implementation of money? Because for me, what is half of the discussion is crypto money is better and have to be investing in that asset class. And my conclusion right now is Bitcoin is the best option right now. But we will be for sure studying that. So what is the main value proposal of Bitcoin in order to be a recap of that, because we are not going to enter in that. But for me, this is almost the four main things. But it's a best hard money implementation. So if you have too much money, really, you have you are going to save better. Are you going to have a better money than the soft money that we are using, fiat? So that's a very good book about Bitcoin standard that you can read about that. The other thing is censorship and resistance. So that is for use, for sure, a use case in out of country that there are people who really doesn't have some government that force to this wealth. Okay, that's for sure another utility. This is an uncorrelated asset. So even if you are an investor in a point of view investor, you have to recognize that Bitcoin in the last 5 years was the best asset class in the world and was really one of the most uncorrelated asset in the world. Even this year is also the best asset in the world. So if you are an investor and you are not investing in that kind of asset, you have lost one of the most creation value of the last 5 years. We have created more than 3 billion creation value, and if you are not in that kind of crypto asset, you are have lost some part of it. And for sure, there is another kind of discussion about crypto capitalism, a crypto economy that is creating a new kind of economy in the network globally. That is for sure another kind of advantage. So let's go into deep in what is the price, what was the title of this conference. So we have to approach if you want to establish a price of Bitcoin, you have to approach in two ways. One is comparable. We have to compare with other kind of asset class. What it makes sense? What can it achieve? Okay? Because if you think Bitcoin, nobody knows really what is Bitcoin. And there are a lot of narrative of people who think that Bitcoin is a payment method, that is a store of value, that there are a lot of things. The battle of a store of value has been won. There are more than 200 billion of wealth in Bitcoin. So a lot of people for sure consider that is an asset where you can really store value. So this battle has been won. The other thing is there are another kind of battles. So you have to decide. So that's why sometimes people fork the Bitcoin. Because if you are in a community that you think this has to be a payment network and you are not agree with other part of Bitcoin network, you create a fork and you try to focus the implementation of Bitcoin Cash in payment methods. So I am being focused in Bitcoin Core. That is what I think is half most value, in order to concrete in details. Okay. So in terms of asset classes, as we know, we are not so relevant. So as you can see, a lot of things that all the anti-money laundering is doing by Bitcoin is not. Bitcoin is not so huge, first of all, and the second is not statistically true. There are only 1% of the activity that. Some studies say that there is illicit activity, so that's not the place. So this is Bitcoin right now. There are a lot of asset classes where we can do. Okay, let me think if Bitcoin will be the substitute of gold. That is one of the many scenarios that people is right now having. If we think that Bitcoin is a substitute, if in that case, people, if Bitcoin will go to the to really substitute gold, the price of Bitcoin will be $400,000. That could happen. Probably it's not only a change of asset, it's a change of our society. If we achieve this level until the society really believes that it's better than gold, probably we'll be in a bubble. But could happen that people could store more wealth in Bitcoin than in gold was. There are some kind of, even with the new people, new generation, that is becoming this the real, more preferable asset than the gold. And they have a lot of really good excuses to use Bitcoin instead of gold. The other thing about that is important, I don't have time, but it's important to consider, is a better, is real, Bitcoin really is a better implementation on scarcity. When I bought one portion of Bitcoin. I know what percent of Bitcoin I will have every in my life. But if you have one time of gold, every time, every year, there are a lot of mining of gold. You don't know really what that. So the only really scarcity asset in the world is Bitcoin. The other, they can produce more, okay? Even gold is probably the most difficult to produce. Bitcoin, as we know, we cannot. It would be 25 million. So this is another kind of conversation. Are really 20 million of Bitcoins what we have to consider when we consider the price? What we consider, we have make the math, what will be Bitcoin if we go to the gold? We did it, this math with 20 million. But the thing is, there are not 20 million really Bitcoins in the market. Because there are people, a lot of people who lost Bitcoins. And there are some lost Bitcoins lost. How much Bitcoins are lost? Well, the blue line is the Bitcoin that has been not moved in the last more than five years have been not moved. And we see that there are some 1 million Bitcoins from Satoshi, I think, that we think that are lost. But I know a lot of people, sadly, that has lost some Bitcoin. And even if someone right now died, probably, and they didn't have, they didn't pass the password, probably will lose. So for sure, every time, every year, there is like a percentage of Bitcoin lose. So the price, you have to adjust the calculation to less than 20 million Bitcoins, okay? So, but we have to this number. So if that number is implies that our society will really adopt Bitcoin better than gold, and that for sure will need time to happen. So that for sure is a big, big achievement. The other thing is we consider Bitcoin as money, okay? We can consider, could be this a money that will be used more than other kind of money countries? So because we think it is a better implementation of money, in that case, and if we rank all the monies all over the world, well, right now it's more than 45 Bitcoin, so we can achieve to go to the top 10 monies. It will achieve, imagine that this money will surpass US dollar or Japanese yen or something like that. We can estimate what will be the price of Bitcoin if this will happen, okay? Well, but if we go to a 20 trillion capitalization, the Bitcoin will really be $1 million of dollars, okay? Can this happen? Probably not as soon as we think, and probably this as the top of we can really, or the best scenario that we can have. In order to have, what are our limits? Because we have to have limits in our price, and we know to what world it can go, okay? So that probably are the selling price that we can do in the best scenario possible. Well, we are not counting in inflation, we are not counting that we have less Bitcoin, so we have to adjust that, and we have to do a lot of them. But this is the context that we can, the kind of calculation that we can do in order to do what are the range that we are managing, okay? But going deep into Bitcoin valuation more in depth, okay? More in a more fundamental way. We have, like said, the range that we can achieve in the best scenarios that it's okay to have, because if we achieve at these levels, if we are not in a better scenario, we are in a bubble, okay? But we are going to see in another way. We are going to see in simple fundamental ideas that we all can share. Okay, one of the, I cannot develop all the fundamental ideas, but what I can share with you is we have to agree with me that more secure is Bitcoin, more value they have, if it have. So we can agree that if Bitcoin doesn't have any security, the value will be with zero. So that's for sure we have to imply in the valuation of Bitcoin. If it have more security, it will be more valuable, okay? That's one of the points that you have to develop in this kind of strategies. So how is immutable anything or any kind of things are immutable? So we have to talk in range of how much it costs to attack Bitcoin. Because something is more secure because not because it cannot be attacked, because it's more expensive to attack this kind of. So in this moment, really, proof of work is the most secure consensus protocol. I think proof of stake have to show this kind of security, but right now it's not as the same state. Even proof of work, there are not so much proof of work that have the same security as Bitcoin. As you can see here, Bitcoin is far away of the next one. So if we can really see a substitute of Bitcoin, we have to at least to have the same security or to have more security at Bitcoin. There can be a signal of Bitcoin is not the best option, okay? So right now it's really, really, really difficult, not in terms of money, in terms also because of the energy cost, the mining. So there are more explanation about what is based the security of Bitcoin. But the thing is, the reality, in 10 years, nobody can hack Bitcoin. So that's really, time is also important. But if we measure the cost of attacking in Bitcoin, we can do in another way. We can see what is the budget that Bitcoin spent in securitizing the network. And this could be calculated by the revenue of the miners. The revenue of the miners plus the commissions. So right now, there are like 5 billion of budget that people can waste in order to secure Bitcoin. And that is a lot of money. So think that this is a network that has 5 billion of money securitizing the network. When people say that Bitcoin doesn't value anything, doesn't consider that there is an important decentralized security model that costs money, okay? So if we evaluate this with Visa, we can really evaluate this with Visa, like a company that also secure this kind of networks. Well, Visa generates 20 billion revenue, okay? And right now, the market cap is $400 billion. So right now, Visa is double worth it than Bitcoin. And I think that Bitcoin is more secure than Visa network. And even they have a lot of things, a lot of reasons why I will invest more in Bitcoin than in Visa, for a lot of reasons. But right now, it's not as cheap as Visa network, as Visa as a company, okay? That's another way to evaluate, okay? There are more ideas to try to measure how can Bitcoin could work. One will be how many people is going to in Spain there are 45 million population. We have unsafe nets around 50,000 of euros in median. So if what happens is people decide to invest to in Spain only, and the half of Spain decide to invest all the wealth, the half of the wealth in Bitcoin. How much will be stored in Bitcoin? Okay, that implies in that case, in this scenario, 3 million of Bitcoin nation population and 100,000 of dollars stored in that. The Bitcoin will store the value that could make the price goes to $50,000. Okay, so one of the things that we can really track is how many people is becoming new in Bitcoin, how much money is able to save in Bitcoin. So that for sure will be, if there are nobody who is right now saving in Bitcoin, probably there will be no use case for Bitcoin. But if we see all the time more and more people saving wealth in Bitcoin, that could happen. Okay, there are a lot of more approach to fundamental approach to Bitcoin. We can evaluate by transaction. How much is, you have to agree with me, if there are more transactions in Bitcoin, it will be more valuable. There are some kind of fundamental approach like Metalcalf that try to evaluate companies like Facebook in a network effect. So because some kind of companies, the fundamental value grows exponentially with the users. There is some theory about that. So we can also apply to this. We can also to recognize what is the brand valuation. We have to do a lot of things, and this is what really explains, you know, to have an approach of what really is the price, what is Bitcoin worth or not, okay? That's when people talk that Bitcoin has no value, I think really it does not consider a lot of the things and a lot of the main intrinsic value that they have. So that's first approach, and sometimes also I think there's a very good there is also an opportunity when you are in markets that timing is very important. When you invest in Bitcoin and you invest in other things, sometimes you have to consider is a good moment to invest today? Was a good moment to invest in the last part of the year? So that for that thing, we usually invest, use some technical analysis in order to avoid trends and to do a good timing in order to invest, okay? I think right now I create my fund in the last part of this, the 2017, but in that moment was beginning the market in a very strength. So I start my crypto fund in just when the lines cross, because we thought that this was a, we are really in a very, very emotional market. So some people, there are some inertia in our narratives. Some people think that they don't have lose, they have, Bitcoin has died and we stay for a lot of time. And we have other kinds of moments that we people love Bitcoin. So we have to understand that this kind of asset move in that way. And also there are other kind of tools like this. Okay, this a friend of us, we are in the Congress, that has tools like into the block that permits to know how many people right now are losing in Bitcoin and how many people is in a position that losing money. The thing is right now, and the people usually talk a lot that the people has losing a lot of money. It's really, really difficult to lose in an asset like Bitcoin. So there are not so many people that are losing money in Bitcoin, because only in 3 months, I think, the price stay up to $3,000. So only the people who bought in that moment right now are losing money. So almost, and these kind of tools identify where are right now the value at the last transaction of each wallet in Bitcoin, and say all the green green circles are people who are with a winning position. So right now, really, there are a lot of people who are winning. There are about 95% of people right now in the last transaction that is winning money. Okay. So that's the main point. So I think, as Benjamin Graham says, I think market is really, really one of the best way to give a price to an asset class, to a company. I think sometimes the market in the short terms are trying to put in a consensus. There are people who think they have value, the other that have value. It's like a voting machine. But in the long term, the market will really discover the right price. And that's why I think, and I think we are really in a moment that we are really achieving that. In the long term, as you know, the market is recognizing the value that has Bitcoin. And even with this volatile movement, I think most of people is thinking that this has value. And right now, that's why the long term movement is upside. Anyway, as we will see, there are a lot of competition in the crypto money technology. So we are seeing right now the first implementation of money, as in each of the markets, and as you can see in technology companies, because right now this is a technology contest. We will see that Bitcoin will be challenged with other implementation of crypto money, as Microsoft or as a lot of companies like IBM has been challenged for another technology companies. Okay, so as you know, every 5 years there are some technology companies that are substituted for other technology companies. So we have to identify when this could happen. There are some companies like Facebook that can survive even in some generation of big technology movements. But what important for me, the last conclusion is, I think crypto money is here to stay. It's a superior technology and for sure will be used if some company, government, or people want to compete in this world, because the thing you can do with crypto money is much superior than digital money. In that creation of value. Bitcoin right now has a lot of difference with the other competitors, so it's in another level. So 10 years, decentralized, not hacked. So right now it's very, very difficult to justify that there is a competitor that will be substitute. Libra, for sure, will be, I don't know, a competitor in that long-term race. But in case we will discover another technology that will really compete with Bitcoin to doing something better, we will be to include in our portfolio. So I think the best way to invest in crypto money is to have a portfolio con the best possible implementation of money. Right now, I think Bitcoin probably is the best one. So for sure, you have to have almost all your investment in that. But you have to be careful to understand better what are the main competitive edge and will be the next crypto money, or even if Bitcoin can really survive and adapt to this competition of crypto money. So not why I hope you can understand better why I think, in my opinion, Bitcoin has a lot of value. It's an opinion, it's not an investment advice or something like that. But I really believe in the long term. I really believe in crypto money. Sometimes I will invest in that kind of asset class.